Thanks, my friend.
Have you ever lost your way? Have mercy, thinking about yesterday. I was barefoot in the creek, singing songs came out of the street, and my heart was free as a breeze. Long before you were broken, long before harsh words were spoken, there was nothing to rise above, just to go where the love is, yeah, go where the love is, yeah, go,
go
where the love is, and you won't be lost again. Is where you gonna go? Go,
go
where the love is. Yeah, go,
go
where the love is, and you won't be lost again. Have you ever gone astray, grown weary, been all out of faith? Have you ever, like me, what you gonna do? Go,
go
where the love is. Go,
go
where the love is. Yeah, go,
go
where the love is, and you won't be lost again. Go,
go
where the love is. Go,
go
where the love is. Be lost again.
Awesome. Good morning. My name is Michael Showalter, and it's my honor to serve as your representative to the Unity Board of Trustees. I invite you to please take out your electronic devices. If you're on social media, check in and let people know you're here at Unity Minneapolis. Then please, in consideration of yourself, of others, and of this sacred place, if you can, please turn off your cell phone or set it on airplane mode. It'd be appreciated. Thank you. We share a common vision to celebrate a world transformed. Our approach to transforming this world can be found in our mission, and namely that is to inspire, empower, full expression of the divine within you through prayer, education, and service. Every week, Unity Minneapolis provides the opportunities to continue your inner transformation through prayer, education, and service. And here's a few examples of the opportunities that are coming here soon. This very afternoon at 1:30, you're invited to join our special guest, Esther Nicholson, for her Keys to Abundant Living Workshop. That's today here at 1:30. Esther's also offering private counseling sessions here tomorrow afternoon. If you're interested, contact the church office or go out here and you will find Esther after the service. Here's a rundown of the week. The office is closed tomorrow in honor of the Martin Luther King holiday, but we will be open for evening activities. So the church is open in the evening. The office is closed during the day. Men's group is Tuesday night at 6:30. Also Tuesday night, Mary Morrissey's new Prosperity Plus 3 kicks off here Tuesday night. Reverend Pat's book group continues Thursday mornings at 10:30. On this coming Saturday, there's an introduction to breathwork at 2 o'clock. There's Meet the Parents at 7 o'clock. And then next Sunday kicks off in the morning with our meditation service. Wonderful. Here from 8:30 to 9. And then Reverend Sandy McKinney will lead an invitation to possibility workshop in the afternoon at 1:30. That's next Sunday. There's a lot more information and a lot more events. You can find them in your bulletins, in your insert, out here in the garden court. And if you're in the garden court, you can also sign up for the peak of the week. That's four ways to transform your life and learn more about all the opportunities to do so. Now, if it's agreeable to your mind, please be here and be now. Give yourself the gift of this sacred honor, this hour, by being here and being present right now. Let's begin our service with prayer led by Reverend Pat.
Join me in prayer. I invite you, if you would, just to take that deep breath with me and let go. And surrender again to that infinite, invisible presence within, knowing without a doubt that this presence within truly guides and directs our life. We are truly grateful to be here this morning. We're grateful for the opportunity to come together in spiritual community, to learn from each other, to feel each other's energy and presence. And for that, we're grateful. And together, we say, thank you, God. Together, thank you, God, and so it is, amen. The few, the proud, the Marines, thank you for being here this morning. It's a beautiful Minnesota day. Let's applaud this day, okay? We begin our service by using affirmations. The affirmations are found in your order of service. Our core values are, together may we affirm, together. We are loving, transforming, welcoming, spirit-filled, prosperous, and joyful. And now our vision statement. Together, centered in spirit, we celebrate a world transformed by love, peace, and compassion. And our mission statement. Together, we are a vibrant, inclusive, prosperous, spiritual community, inspiring and empowering full expression of the divine within through prayer, education, and service. Inviting our on-duty Unity Prayer Chaplains to please stand. These individuals arrived early. They held sacred space in this beautiful sanctuary, and they're here today in service to you and with you. They're here to hold that sacred space, to listen with the ears of their heart, to pray aloud with you, and then to hold what they have heard in the strictest of confidence. So today, if you have a prayer request, by all means, seek out a Unity Prayer Chaplain. Thank you for your service. Now let us all stand together as we sing Witness. The words are in your program.
Purpose to all that I may.
is a witness to my holy purpose, to all that I'm born to be.
Yeah.
Let it in, let it flow, let it go where it will go. Let the power of your presence show the way. Let's hear about your life.
Thank you, and please be seated. You notice that one of our core values is that of welcoming. Therefore, one of our favorite things to do here at Unity Minneapolis is to welcome our guest. So this morning, if you're with us for the first, second, or third time, please allow us to honor your presence here this morning. We invite you, if you would, just to take that deep breath, take your courage in your hand, and raise your hand as I raise my hand. Calling on courage out there. Keep those hands up. Courage. First, second, and third time guest. Keep your hands up, please. Thank you, Lori. Thank you. Keep those hands up, please. That packet of information you're receiving tells you a lot about Unity Minneapolis. There's a card in that packet. If you choose to fill out any part of that card and turn that into our book desk, we have a gift for you in the bookstore. The rose is a gift from our congregation so that we can easily recognize you and give you a very personal welcome. All of us important, and yet one of the most important things that's said on this platform each and every Sunday morning is this. And that is, my dear friends, wherever you are on your spiritual journey, wherever that may be, you're welcome here. We welcome you. We bless you. We behold the living presence of the divine within you. Let's appreciate these guests again, please. And of course, we welcome those that are live streaming with us today as well. We're glad that you have decided to join us. We welcome each other. We do that with a handshake, a hug, a smile, namaste. We always ask before. Let's do it right now, okay? So if you did not get a chance to speak with the person you wanted to speak with this morning, we invite you to stay for coffee and tea in Friendship Hall following today's service. We are so blessed today to have a very special guest with us. She is the author of Soul Recovery, 12 Keys to Healing Dependency. She's a teacher, a healer, recording artist, and former addict who brings her incredible journey of transformation to a particular curriculum, addressing the causes and the effects of dependency as they occur in contemporary living. She infuses the 12 steps process with added spiritual concepts and teachings that transform the treatment of dependency, addiction, crisis living and suffering through her articles, seminars, soul-nurturing music, and riveting keynote speaking. She is a gifted vocal artist in her own right. Her musical career includes tours with Rod Stewart, Bette Midler, and appearances on such television shows as Oprah, The Tonight Show, The View, Good Morning America, and The Ellen DeGeneres Show. She says, she can say anything she wants to say with those credentials, couldn't she? She says, we are collectively standing at a recovery moment in our history with challenges that face us on so many levels, as people, as businesses, as educators, and as organizations. We are at a point where we need to rethink, retool, and re-engineer our future. For me, that suggests a basis in straight talk, back to our roots thinking, and embracing a future that is consistent with foundational principles common to all of us. I had the opportunity yesterday afternoon to have coffee with our guest. She's a delightful person. She's spoken in probably hundreds of New Thought centers. She's well-known in the Michael Beckwith's community of Agape, and we are truly blessed not only to have her here in our community, we are blessed to have her in Minneapolis. Would you please give a warm Minnesota welcome to Esther Nicholson. Now let's stand together as we sing Namaste. You might need the word Namaste, and we're going to stand, and you might need the words for the first couple of times, and then we're going to take these bulletins and we're going to toss them. And we're going to look at each other like we love each other and like each other and sing Namaste to each other. Let's do it.
Let's sing it again. The God in me beholds the God in you. Namaste. The God in me beholds the God in you. Namaste. All is beautiful. All is well. Is well.
We now move deeper into spirit with the reading of the daily word and the singing of Surely the Presence. As the usher brings down the prayer box, you're invited to mentally add your prayers to the written request in the box. After the service, the prayer box is located in the garden court, where you may add your written requests. Your prayers are then prayed with by our prayer ministry for 7 days, and then they are forwarded to Silent Unity, where they are prayed with for an additional 30 days. The word for today is enrichment. Divine love blesses all that I think, say, and do. In the Hebrew scriptures, Jacob dreamed of angels, divine thought messengers, ascending and descending a ramp connected to heaven, the divine realm, and earth, human awareness. In his dream, God promised Jacob that the families of the earth would be blessed through him and his descendants. Upon awakening, Jacob exclaimed, "Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it." When I experience a spiritual awakening, I discover that the divine presence, the indwelling Christ, is within me, even when I do not recognize it. I open my mind and heart to the Christ presence, and my life is enriched in every possible way. Divine love blesses all that I think, say, and do. Genesis 28:16 tells us, "Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, 'Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it.'" The word for today is enrichment.
I invite you to join me in meditation. And if you've not done so, I invite you just to gently close your eyes, closing out the outside world, and begin to breathe deeply. As you bring your attention inward to only that place that you can go, that still small place within, where you know and you feel the divine. Relax. Let go. For this is indeed a safe place. And this morning, I invite you to allow these words to become your words, the words of your heart. With faith, I follow my dreams. With faith, I follow my dreams. The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King once said, faith is taking the first step, even when you don't see the whole staircase. And so this morning, with courage and with faith, we take the first step, even if we do not see our entire dream. We know and give thanks that God is present, and that our dreams have been placed upon our heart by the divine for a reason, for a purpose. And whether our dream of writing a book, sailing around the world, or affecting positive change in my community, I must take the first step, even though the whole staircase may not be visible. And in this awareness, and in this truth and understanding, I rest just for a moment in the stillness and in the quiet. I take the first step, and as I do, I am free to accept the good that God has for me. I am free to begin anew in a new way. We feel God's presence today. And today we pray with our prayer ministry, our prayer chaplains, our Unity Cares ministry, our healing ministry. We pray with these ministries within our community, for they indeed hold the high watch for us when we often forget. So again, let me invite you just to take that deep breath, and as you do, begin to return to this time and this place, knowing that we have truly been in the kingdom of God, the kingdom of spirit. Say thank you. Thank you, God. Amen.
Good morning. What's up? Take a nice deep breath. So I want to sing to you about forgiveness. Is that okay? So I want you to just call someone in your consciousness right now that you believe has caused you harm. I don't want you to do anything with it. I just want you to bring them right here in your heart and your consciousness. And I want you to visualize you singing this song to them. Yes? Story about a man who stood in his truth with such conviction in who he would not be moved. Someone stepped out of the crowd and said, "Are you Martin Luther King?" He said, "Yes, I am," and the well-dressed man spit on him, King took out his handkerchief and wiped the hate from his suit. He gave it back to the man and said, I believe this belongs to you. I will lift you. Stories. You see, I had a story. I once had a powerful story I used to carry around. I thought it was you all this time who held my spirit down. But now I know the truth of who I came here to be. You are my angel in disguise, not my enemy. So I thank you for the part you played in this dance we had to do. I give you back the love that's real. I believe this belongs to you. Sing with me. I will lift you. Amen. The title of my talk today, first of all, before I even get into that, what's up, Unity? Yes? Yeah. The title of my talk today is Homesick for Your Real Self. You're homesick to return to your authentic self, and your authentic self is homesick for you. It's like, come on home. Yes? And so I want to share with you what I believe is the most powerful, practical, efficient, effective roadmap and GPS system. It's not like Siri, who ends you up in a ditch sometimes. This is a direct roadmap and GPS, perfect GPS. Back home to your authentic self by way of recovery. Now, I'm not talking about recovering from something, from anything, like a financial or physical or emotional crisis. We're not talking about recovery from the perspective of from something. I want to talk about the recovery of that essential part of your nature that is referenced in Genesis, where God looked around at everything it had made and said, behold, it is good and very good. Say, I'm good and very good. I'm good and very good. I want to talk about the reawakening to your essential nature and your divine birthright of worthiness. Let me hear you say worthiness. And I want to talk about the rediscovery. Now, I spoke with Reverend Pat about this, and he said, I think they'll be cool. I want to talk about the rediscovery of your badass sexiness. Can I get an amen? How many of y'all like feeling sexy? Don't lie. Everybody raise your hand. I used to think that being sexy had to do with how much weight I gained or lost, or the kind of clothes I wore, or how I wore my makeup. But I came to realize that as long as I was walking around with that life-diminishing, insidious belief of unworthiness, not enoughness, and undeservingness, that I couldn't suck it up, tone it up, color it up, no matter how hard I tried. That illusion would follow me wherever I went. And it would make decisions on my behalf without my conscious decision. Can I get an amen? Because it is insidious. Say insidious. The definition of insidious is subtle, underhanded, cunning, baffling, and powerful, and relentless. Meaning it's making decisions through you from this automatic, hardwired, conditioned belief that you're not even aware of. But let me give you an example of what unworthiness, undeservingness, and not enoughness looks like. It looks like you're saying yes when you really mean no. It looks like not being able to stand in your truth from a place of spiritual discernment and speak up for yourself. It looks like having unhealthy boundaries. And it looks like, and it feels like, accepting something in your life that you know in your soul it's too small for you. You know that it's not what you really want, but you accept it. You say yes to it, not because you want it, but because unworthiness tells you that's all you can have. And I remember a while ago I was in negotiations with a potential client, and I was having a great day. And this is how insidious it is. I was having a great day. And I get this phone call from this potential client. We're talking and we're negotiating. And all of a sudden, I get this sinking feeling in the pit of my gut. How many of you have gotten that feeling in the pit of your gut before? And I was like, oh, what's the matter, sweetheart? I call myself sweetheart. I said, what's the matter, sweetheart? And it was like, that something doesn't feel right. It just doesn't feel good. And what I realize is that the illusion of unworthiness, it's not because I was negotiating with a client, it's because the illusion of unworthiness was seeking to negotiate with the truth of my beingness, and it wasn't a match. Can I get an amen? It wasn't a vibrational match. And I looked, I said, oh my God, I can't make decisions from that place anymore. That is not who I am. I want you to say, I can't do it anymore. I can't make decisions from that place anymore. So I said, okay, well, I'm not going to make a decision from that place. But because this illusion is so insidious and it sneaks in through the back door, it said, well, ha! If I can't make a decision from that place, then here's where I'll make it from. How dare they? How dare they offer me something like that? Don't they know who I am? I'm Esther Nicholson. And I felt in, checked in. And it still didn't feel right. I was like, well, why doesn't that feel right? And it was because unworthiness will mask itself as self-righteous arrogance, just like it will mask itself as shrinking and being smaller than who you are. Amen. And so I had to go into my closet. I said, I can't make a decision from that place, and I can't make a decision from that place. I got to go within. I got to tap into this infinite wisdom, this divine clarity that is always within us. It is always operating, just waiting for us to align, waiting for us to give it permission to come through as the activity of our consciousness. And by the time I came out of my inner closet doing the soul recovery work that I want to teach you about this weekend, the decision that I had come to was I was going to leave the deal on the table. Leave the deal on the table and walk away with nothing. Because here's what I know. When you walk away with nothing in the name of your self-value, when you walk away with nothing in the name of truth, in the nature of God, in the nature of your wholeness and your worthiness, that the inexhaustible good of the universe will fill that seeming nothingness with the divine something that is beyond your wildest imagination. Can I get an amen? Say, leave it on the table. Walk away with nothing. And watch what fills that void. The demonstration. The glory of God in, as, and through you. And so, this talk is so important to me because so many people come to me with help with their financial, their emotional, their addiction issues. And when we unpack what's really going on, we invariably find that underneath the condition is the illusion that they are not good enough, not worthy, and undeserving. And it's not a vibrational match with the glory of God that is within you, that is nearer than your hands and feet, closer than your breath. Can I get an amen? So here's what I've come to know. And I know that you know this too, but I'm going to remind you of this today. When you have reconnected to home, when you have come home to your authentic self, unworthiness and all those emotional addictions, they don't need to be healed because in the mind of God, they don't even exist. Say it's a lie. It doesn't exist. It's not true. When you have come home, when you have reconnected, when you have tapped in and tuned in to your true identity. So, because here's the thing. You may have been born into dysfunction, but you were created out of greatness. Can I get an amen? So when you tap into that truth of who you are, here's who you are. You are empowered. Let me hear you say empowered. Confident. Clear. Centered. Grounded. Free. And you walk into your purpose without hesitancy because when you're home, you feel safe. Can I get an amen to just feeling safe? And for a woman like me who couldn't sleep with the light out until I was 26 years old, who was plagued by chronic anxiety, feeling safe is priceless. Feeling safe, independent of anything or anybody external to yourself, that's freedom. That's God. Can I get an amen? So what is it costing you, beloved? What is it costing you to make decisions from a place of unworthiness? Is it costing you your health? Is it costing you your financial security? Is it costing you the ability to live your purpose with freedom? What is it costing you? I think the cost is too high. Can I get an amen? Because here's the thing. Your desires and who you really are and that vision of how you see yourself, it's not that you're not worthy of it. Your negative thoughts are unworthy of you. It's not that you're not worthy of what you want, because scripture says, boo, I have come to give you life, and I have come to give it abundantly. Yeah, I called you boo. And I have come to give it abundantly. And so when we're thinking opposite of that, when we're thinking, I can't, I don't know how, I'm not enough, those thoughts are not worthy of you. And so I'm here to get you home this weekend, if you allow me to. And as I said, one of the most powerful, efficient, effective roadmaps that I know to get you back, to support you in taking this journey back in consciousness to who you were before you even landed in your mother's womb, before your story, before your traumas, before the lies that took root in your consciousness, getting back to that place. The most powerful process that I know of is based in the 12 steps of recovery, which are pure universal principles. The 12 steps of recovery combined, unified with metaphysical principles and other powerful healing modalities like EFT, which just clears up the noise, awakens you from the dream, and awakens you to home. And I call this process, I call this work soul recovery. Now, soul recovery not only has the power to effectively address and heal those obvious life-threatening addictions that we are so familiar with, like the drugs and alcohol and food and all of that. They have the power to address and heal and get you home regarding those more subtle, insidious, life-diminishing addictions, like the addiction to the belief that somehow you're not worthy or not good enough or undeserving, the addiction to the belief in chronic fear and worry, the addiction to procrastination by way of distraction, in particular, distraction by way of the internet and social. Okay, I'm getting ready to preach right now. The internet and social media, and please let's not forget about Netflix. You press a button, you click on a movie on Netflix, knowing darn well you're clicking on a series. And we all know that there's 13 to 18 episodes in a series. And you click on that series, and you come to 3 or 4 days later. Zoned out. Numbed out. Dumbed out. Feeling horrible because I have, again, gone a whole week without working on my purpose, without being home, and the vicious cycle continues. I know how important this work is because I had to find a way to heal my stuff. And I found that way 33 years ago. I've been in recovery 33 years now. Thank you. And where I lost my child to addiction and in and out of treatment centers, and the day of this sweet grace, my journey of spiritual and emotional recovery, which I'm really talking to you about today, it came with this sweet grace in the form of a taxi driver who I had hailed to take me into the hood to buy some drugs. And instead of doing what I instructed him to do, he turned to face me and he said, "Young lady, please don't kill yourself today." And I looked into the eyes of this angel disguised as a taxi driver, and the veil of illusion parted. Say, the veil parted. And I caught a glimpse of home. I caught a glimpse of who I was created to be in the mind of God. I caught a glimpse of freedom. I caught a glimpse of bliss. I caught a glimpse of wholeness and worthiness. And I became homesick for that. And that was the beginning of my long road. Sometimes it's a long road to emotional and spiritual recovery and rediscovery. Why? Because addiction is insidious. So let me just explain what addiction is in case some of you all are thinking, boy, this would have been a great talk for my sister. She's an addict, you know. I'm like, no, boo, I think this is about you. So addiction is when you are so attached to a conditioned belief system, thought pattern, or behavior pattern that you become enslaved or in bondage to it to the degree that even though you really, 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 really want to change it and heal, you just can't seem to. And you keep defaulting back to what's familiar, even though that familiar pattern is causing pain in your life. And you might think it's impossible to ever heal that. You might be in a situation right now or experiencing something right now where it just feels impossible to heal that. And I want to share with you, my beloved sisters and brothers, from a place of disconnection, from a place of not being home, it is impossible. Say, it is impossible. Say, when I'm not connected, it's impossible. Maya Angelou told Oprah, "When I'm not connected, I'm in danger and I'm dangerous." Yes? So actually the first step of recovery is admitting that, is being so convinced of that, that from a disconnected place, from when I have run away from home and consciousness, it is impossible to heal this. So let's stop trying to figure it out right now. Let's stop trying to fix it right now from the place that created it in the first place, as Einstein said. So the first step to the recovery, reawakening, and rediscovery and reconnection to your soul, to your authentic self, is admitting that you of yourself can't do it. Is admitting that you of yourself don't have to do it. And this creates this spaciousness, this openness, this connection while you're admitting personal powerlessness, it gets your egoic limited sense of power out of the way so that you can tap into the infinite power that can do for you, through you, as you, what you have never been able to do for yourself. So you do this, and now you're starting to feel the flow. Now things are starting to become easier because you're not pulling and pushing up against your own self. You're not battling yourself. There's a freedom. There's a sense of, oh, man, oh, something's happening. I'm starting to feel something that feels familiar. It's who I really am. I don't know how to hold on to it right now, but I'm starting to feel it. And so what are you starting to feel? That maybe in the second step you can come to believe that there's a power greater than yourself that is your real self that can restore you back to who you were created to be. Because here's the thing in the second step of recovery. You can't be restored back to something that was never the truth about you in the first place. You are restored. Scripture says he restoreth my soul, meaning restoring something that got lost. But it's still there. And how does that happen? Because in the third step, we make a decision to turn our will, our life, our patterns, our fears, our little life. Scripture said, if you try to hold on to your little life, you will lose your soul. But if you give up your little life in my name what? My nature, the truth of who I am, you will have life eternal. And you make a decision to turn your will and your life over to the care of this power, to the best of your ability. It says, to the care of this power as you understand it. And I like to say, if the God of your understanding ain't working for you, then it's time to get a new God, or it's time to get a new understanding. Can I get an amen? Because God, life, the infinite, is good, y'all. Sometimes I'm so out of the way because I'm so convinced. You don't even have to convince me anymore that of myself I am dangerous and I am in danger. I am so convinced. I feel this presence. I watch this presence. I glorify this presence as my life. And I just break it down. I say, God, you are so showing off right now. God shows off. Say, God's showing off as me, through me. Not because it's doing anything for you, and not because it's withholding anything for you. God can't do nothing for you. God is. Say, God is. So this work, getting out of the way. Say, I got to get on up out the way. Get on up out the way. When you get out of the way, you tap into this infinite power that can do for you what you cannot do for yourself. You come to believe that this power, this greater power, is nearer than your hands and feet, closer than your breath. It's just a higher vibration than what you're accustomed to operating. And you surrender. And you even surrender your surrender, because I know that you don't know how to surrender. I don't know how to surrender, but there's a power within me that can surrender me with such grace, with such love. And then you dive deeper into forgiveness. Do you know what it took for Martin Luther King to forgive? He had to know of a power greater than his limited self. He had to tap into a vibration and a power that was beyond his limited knowledge and his limited power to forgive. And then there is the more, as we get deeper into the process, it's precise, it's concise, it's effective. And as you're doing this, you're waking up. You're waking up. You're waking up. You're coming home. You're coming home. And things are starting to shift. Things are starting to happen. Things are amazing in your life. And you understand that it's not because you're lucky. It's not because you're favored or any of that. It's because you lined up. Because you got out of the way. And now, beloved, now from this place of being transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now when you speak your word, it's not Sally speaking her word, hoping that it comes through. It is the God within you declaring itself anew in, as, and through you. And you know it. You feel the power. And you have awakened to home. And when you awaken to home, you realize, oh my God, I never left at all. I was just having a dream. Like Dorothy. She woke up after having this dream, this crazy dream, in her own bed. That's where you are. You're already home. But you awaken. You feel the presence and power within. You say, oh my God, my beloved has come home. Bring out the finest robes. Bring out the finest food. Bring out the finest, because I have come to give you life abundantly. But you got to come home. You got to come to that vibrational frequency that is already operating within you, but you can't catch it. You can't glimpse it. You can't experience it if you're operating down here. And that's not from a place of judgment. It's from a place of awareness. Where am I hanging out? Steps, the work. I'm home. And so I bless you in coming home. I invite you to come home. We miss you. The real you misses you, and you miss the real you. And so if there's anything that I can do to support you in getting home to who you really are, then please come see me. I have some stuff for you. But I welcome you. I welcome you back, because I'm going to tell you right now, and I'm going to end. There's absolutely, and I'm not saying this to be cute or anything like that, there's no place like home. There is no place like being in that presence and power, and you're not afraid anymore, and you're not worried anymore, and you can just relax and just be. I'm telling y'all, for someone like me, that God has been able to glorify itself through as a peace that passeth understanding. I was given this message to give to you. And so if it can be done through me, I welcome you home, because it can be done in, as, and through you as well. Welcome. Welcome back. Peace and blessings. Are we singing again?
Yeah.
All right. So how many of y'all know? You can start playing, babe. So how many of y'all know I used to sing with Rod Stewart, and he fired me because I'd reached a weight and an age that was no longer appropriate to sing Hot Legs behind Rod Stewart. So I want to ask you something right now. This is all in fun, but have you seen Rod lately? I have since thanked him for firing me and kicking me out to my greatness, because the illusion of unworthiness would have had me holding on to somebody else's vision. You are not meant to pull over and park in somebody else's vision. Get on up, y'all. Let's party. Come on, y'all. So I dedicate this song to Mr. Stewart. That's what he does. I dedicate this song to Mr. Stewart, and I dedicate this song to you, because when we are home, this is what we are. All right. Ha. May the good Lord be with you down every road you roam. Woo! And may sunshine and happiness surround you when you're far from home. And may you grow to be proud, dignified, and true. Do unto others as you have done to you. Be courageous and be brave. And in my heart, you will remain. Come on. Oh, y'all got it. Let me hear you say. Guiding light be strong. Feel the could ever tell. But whatever road you choose, God's right behind you. You cannot lose. On ya. Woo! Come on, people, sing it. I said, oh yeah, oh yeah.
I've been to church this morning, have you? Whoa. Thank you. I have cried, I have laughed, I have gotten new insights, and I bet you have too this morning. So I'm going to invite you to make a gift to Unity Minneapolis this morning. I'm going to invite our ushers to come forth as we prepare to receive our tithes and our gifts and our offerings. If you're streaming with us today, we invite you to make a gift to Unity Minneapolis as well. You can do so on our secured website. So let us just go within again. Go within and know who we are, our true, authentic selves. And know that regardless of what is happening in our life, that we are indeed worthy. For we are indeed a child of God. And this morning we give. We give from a source that is ever flowing through us, and that we are grateful. So together, we say, thank you, God. Together, thank you, God. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you.
So let us take a moment and just breathe and bless these gifts, knowing and giving thanks for that law of blessing, those things we bless increase in our life. So we bless these gifts. We bless the gifts that's been received in the mail this week. We bless those participating in our consistent giving program, unexpected income program. We bless all of these gifts, and we send them forth to fulfill our vision and mission of a transformed world. Thank you. Thank you, God. And so it is, and so we let it be. Amen. This Tuesday night, I begin teaching and co-facilitating a course this Tuesday night called Prosperity Plus 3. Many of you have taken prosperity courses here before, but this is a new course offered to our community, and we invite you to participate in that. Kashid Parakh is going to come forth and share with us why she is participating in it. She's taken prosperity courses before. Come on up, Sheree.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Kashid Parakh. And before I talk about Pathways to Prosperity, you know, I've always wondered what it's like to be up here. And I have to say, you all look amazing.
They do.
It's great to be here with you today, and I'm going to share some thoughts about Pathways to Prosperity. I'm relatively new to Unity. I started attending in September 2017 at a time in my life of transition and uncertainty, and I was searching for some answers. I'm sure a lot of you can relate to that. I was in between jobs and starting a job search. My friend Margie Olson invited me to attend Pathways to Prosperity 2. Since I was starting to feel some concern about my finances and employment, the title definitely sounded interesting. I'm like, yeah, I could use some prosperity in my life. I knew there was a tithing component, and though I was not earning at the time, my husband and I decided what made sense for us, and I decided to do the class and to begin tithing. As I attended the class, there were two truths that became very clear to me. The first was that prosperity is about so much more than money. I realized that it was possible to be wealthy in money and very poor in all other areas of my life. Working with the principles taught in the class, I now look at my life very differently. And I believe truly that I have much more prosperity in health, connections and relationship, peace of mind, and spiritual wholeness. The second truth is that God really is the source of all my good. This sunk in deep from a cognitive knowing to a deeply emotional one for me. My decision to tithe 10% is only giving back to God 10% of what God gives me. For the first time in many, many years, I stopped worrying about the lack of money, whether I'd have enough, whether I'd be okay in retirement, and all the other thoughts that so many of us share. I still plan and save, but now I don't worry about it. Not because I'm a millionaire, I'm not, but because I've put my trust where it needs to be, in God as the source of all my good. These are a couple of things I learned from the class, and I'm deeply grateful for it. One final thought I'd like to leave you all with. One of the most beautiful things about these classes are the people who attend. Some of the most interesting and powerful takeaways came from the discussions in class and the perspectives that people share. So as you listen to what people say about what they got from these classes, please consider that if you attend and participate, you may share wisdom or perspective that makes it a truly unique experience for somebody else. I hope you will consider giving yourself the opportunity to experience Pathways to Prosperity. I'll see you in class. Thank you.
Kashid, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And Margie Olson will be assisting me in class, and I'm really great to have her there as well. This afternoon, I believe the workshop is at 1:30. Yes, would you say a couple of words about your workshop this afternoon, please, Esther. Thank you.
Hello, everybody, again.
Tuesday, so I wanted to very briefly and quickly let you know what I'm offering while I'm here. First of all, the book Soul Recovery that was released by Hay House is a unification of the 12 steps of recovery and metaphysical principles that take you week by week from the personal powerlessness to the infinite power within you. So that's available, and I'll be happy to sign a copy for you. If you choose to sign up on my email list, you will receive 21 days of free meditation audios that'll be in your email box every morning. I'm also here tomorrow and Tuesday for private client sessions, so if anyone has heard anything today where you feel pulled or compelled to come sit with me one-on-one, please come see me in the back. The workshop this afternoon, Keys to Abundant Living, which I think is a wonderful support for the Prosperity Plus class that you're about to take, because here's what I know. If you are hardwired and conditioned to a belief of lack and limitation and unworthiness, that no matter how many prosperity classes you take, that will continue to pull you back. And so we want to get underneath there with tapping, with renegotiating your old karmic agreements that you had before you even came into this lifetime, the agreements of your parents and your familial beliefs. We want to just heal all of those and have them transmuted and transformed into your wholeness. So that's what this is about. It's from that place, from that exalted place, that when you visualize, you can hold that thought because all the noise that's creating all that static has dissipated. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
So I hope to see you this afternoon. We're going to have a huge forgiveness component in that as well. So I hope to see you this afternoon, and you know, let's start this year off with healing that stuff so that we can be here. Yes?
Yes. Thank you. And a reminder, if you're interested in signing up for the Prosperity Class 3, it begins Tuesday evening, please sign up in the Garden Court so we can have material ready for you. So how are you doing this morning?
Great.
It has been a great and fabulous morning. It really has. I want to do a wonderful shout out for Anna Christie, who's our guest today as well. Anna, we just love having you here. Just love having you here. Thank you. I hear children out there. I know who they belong to. I know who's paying the college tuition. Let's bring them in, okay?
We are walking in the light. In the light of God, in the light of God, in the light of God. Don't you know that you are walking in the light of God, in the light of God. In the light.
Good morning. I want to introduce to you Trina Koning. She has been a volunteer with Youth and Family Ministry for 5 years, and she has a special invitation to parents.
Hi, everybody. Good morning. I'm Trina. So I just want to tell you about the special event we're having next Saturday night from 7 to 9. It's Meet the Parents. So we're going to have a bunch of fun activities and interactive group and small group exercises to get to know each other better and have some fun and get to know not only all the volunteers in the program, but for the parents to get to know each other better. Where, you know, when they're dropping kids off in the classroom, you know, we don't have a lot of time to chat and get to know each other. So this will give us a chance to meet everybody and spend some quality time having fun together, have some snacks, and just have a good time. So please come and tell other parents that you know about it and to join us, and we'd love to see you. Thanks.
Thank you, Trina. Special shout out and thank you for our adult volunteers. Let's appreciate them as well. Now let us know together our prayer for protection and our peace song. Together we know that the light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence. Wherever we are, God is. I am divine, and all is well. And our peace song.
Now there is peace on earth, and it has begun with me. Now there is peace on earth, the peace. Say it again, it's my favorite line.
It's gonna be a bright,
a bright,
a bright, bright
sunshiny day.
I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. Oh, here is the rainbow I've been praying for.
It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Sing it again.
It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day.
Goes in my way, like playing a B flat chord. Gone are those dark clouds that were getting me blind, because I know it's gonna be a bright, very bright, a bright, sunshiny day. Gotta say it again. Hey, it's gonna be a bright, very bright, a bright, a sunshiny day. Come on, Liz.
Sunshiny day.
Very bright, a bright, sunshiny day.